Hello everyone. Welcome to this video on the basic overview of page layout in Bold Reports. A page layout is the arrangement of visual elements like text, images, etc., on a page. First, let me open the customer support analysis report in the Report Designer control. In Bold Reports Report Designer control, the page layout or design area is categorized into header, body, and footer. You can place report items required in the design area to create a report. When previewing or exporting, a report will be generated based on the formatting, page breaks, and properties applied. Let's move on to rendering layouts. Reports can be exported to PDF, Excel, Word, PowerPoint, HTML, CSV or XML file formats. Each file format exports reports based on three types of layouts: soft page break, hard page break, and data layout. Each layout has a set of predefined rules for positioning the report items and determining how much data fits on each page, thereby converting data and report items to a readable format. A soft page break automatically separates pages in Excel, Word, and HTML. It maintains the report layout and formatting. When a report is exported, the exported file has the same output as the preview of the report in the Report Viewer control. And the size of the paper is based on the option selected in the Paper Size property. For this demo, I've selected the paper size as custom and assigned width and height to the report. I export the report to Word format. When I open the exported report, there are no margins applied, and each paper size is the same as the value selected in the paper size property. Then I export the report to Excel and HTML. When I open the exported files, here also you will see no margins applied. Hard page breaks are inserted manually by users to separate pages. The PDF and PowerPoint export follows this layout. Reports exported using PDF file format will have a consistent page size and are suitable for printing. Click the Print Layout icon in the toolbar. Here in the page number section, you will see 2. When you click the next page icon, you will see only a line with the markers chart. When the report is exported to PDF, the output will have the same layout as the print layout. Then I export the report to PowerPoint. When the exported PowerPoint file is opened, you will see a page displayed in each slide and having the same output as the print layout. The data layout clears all layout and formatting from the report and displays only the data. The exported file can be used to import the raw report data into another file type. The CSV and XML export follows this layout. I export the report to CSV. It will only export the data that is used in the report items. In the same way, I export the report to XML format and open the exported report. You will see only the data, but it will not be in the report format. Now, let's see how to use pagination in Bold Reports. Pagination is the number of pages that are added to the report and how report items are placed on the pages. The pagination rules vary based on the rendering extension used to view the report, therefore, the same report will paginate differently depending on the rendering layout used. Reports exported by using the data and soft page break layouts are typically not affected by pagination. But hard page break has the most impact on report layout and physical page size. To control pagination, specify the page-related properties that are provided in the report properties. Soft page break rendering layout is not based on physical pages. Each page size is calculated based on the width and sum of the height of the header, design area, and footer. If the report contains interactive features that may expand the report horizontally or vertically, you cannot control the page breaks with Word, Excel, and HTML formats. Reports rendered in soft page break formats insert page breaks horizontally, based on the physical size, to provide an optimized reading experience when viewed in a web browser. I expand the size of the chart report item and preview the report. You will see the chart size expanded, and the width of the report increased since the width in the design area is also increased. And if the report item's height exceeds the sum of the height of the header, design area, and footer, the remaining items are clipped and displayed in the next page. Hard page break rendering layout is page-oriented format. Therefore, set page properties to control the page breaks in reports when viewed in PDF and PowerPoint. Each page size in the print layout is calculated based on the margin and paper size properties. For this demo, I change the paper size to A4 and preview the report. Click the Print Layout option in the toolbar. You will see the margins added and the report pages clipped in both horizontal and vertical views. When you export the report to PDF, you will see the same report as it was in the print layout. Data rendering layout does not support pagination. Page-related properties specified in the report will be ignored when you view a report in CSV and XML formats. Let's see about the paper size in bold reports. The paper size property, under report properties, defines the pagination when rendered and printing reports in print layout. To change the paper size, click outside the design area. In the properties panel under the paper size category, you will see the properties to change the orientation and paper size of the report. Page orientation is the direction in which a report is displayed or printed. The two basic types are portrait and landscape. The default orientation is portrait. The paper size property is used to select the width and height of the report layout to be used when rendering and exporting. Click the drop-down icon. A list of paper sizes is displayed. Select any size. For example, if you select the A3 size, click the preview button, and then click the print layout icon in the toolbar. You will see all the pages in A3. Export the report to Word format and open it. You will see A3 paper size in the exported file. The custom paper size allows you to set the width and height of the report manually. I change the paper size property value to custom. Width to 800 pixels. And height to 1030 pixels. Export the report in PDF format. When the report body extends outside the page width to the right, the page breaks in horizontal direction. It breaks in vertical direction when the report body extends below the bottom of the page. Now, let's move on to margins in bold reports. A margin is the area between the main content of a page and the page edges, based on the specified margin property. To open the margin property, click outside the design area and open the property panel. Under the margin category, the properties to customize the margins are displayed. The report item will be clipped if it extends into the margin area, and the overlapping area will not be rendered. The margin can be set to zero if margins are not needed. Margins are applied only when you render and print reports in hard page break rendering layout. In the panel, I change the left value to 50 pixels and the top to 150 pixels. Click the preview button and click the page layout option. See, the left and top margins are applied. But, the rectangle, chart, and table report are not displayed. It is displayed in the next page. To avoid this, click the design button and change the left margin to 25 pixels and top to 25 pixels. Let's see how to avoid extra blank pages in print and print preview. Extra blank pages are created when the width of the report is greater than the page width. To avoid this, set the report body width lesser than or equal to the page width. The body width should be less than or equal to page width minus sum of left and right margins. The usable page area remains after the space is allocated for margins, column spacing, page header, and footer. Margins are applied only when the report is rendered in print layout and print reports. To explain this, I preview the product line sales report and click the page layout option in the toolbar. The formula to calculate the horizontal usable area is page width minus sum of left, right margins, and column space. The formula to calculate the vertical usable area is page height minus sum of top, bottom margins, header, and footer height. For example, consider the report width is 21 centimeters. The left margin is 0.5 centimeters. And the right margin is 0.5 centimeters. To avoid an extra printed page in the exported PDF file, the width of the body should be 20 centimeters. And the left and right margins should be 0.5 centimeters. So that the report width will be 21 centimeters. If the width of body is 20 or lesser, it will be rendered without extra pages. When the report is greater than 20 centimeters, extra pages will be added. In this video, I explained a basic overview of page layout in bold reports. Stay tuned to this channel for our upcoming videos on bold reports. Don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.